Hello everybody, this is Dr. Horrible with another Fallout 3 Let's Play. You may remember that in previous episodes, we retrieved the receiver dish from the Virgo 2 Lunar Lander and installed it in the Galaxy News radio station on top of the Washington Monument. Now we can go back to 3Dog and get the information about our father that he was withholding from us. So, let's go do that. Let's continue. Fast travel, because I'm lazy. And I don't want to go through the metro tunnels again. I will not go through the metro tunnels again.
Welcome to D&RPM.
And again, this place is a dump. They could have like one or two soldiers cleaning it, and it could be, and it could look awesome pretty soon. At least comparatively awesome, but no. Hey, 3Dog, wake up. It's, noon. Why aren't you awake?
Power to the people, eh, kid? Hey, all right! The hero of the wasteland returns!
Whatever. Just wanted the information.
And well done indeed. Now GNR can be heard clear across the capital wasteland again. That'll give Eden and those muties something to think about. But before I get back to my calling, I bet you want to hear about your dad.
Well, duh. Where's he?
When your dad passed through here, he and I talked for a good long time. He's a real stand-up kind of guy. He mentioned some scientific mumbo-jumbo, which didn't make sense to me, and mentioned something called Project Purity. He also said something about going to visit a Dr. Lee in Rivet City. Then he left in a hurry.
Rivet City is a city that people built on a abandoned aircraft carrier, not too far away from here, just so you know.
Goodbye. Remember to keep us tuned in while you're out there. And watch yourself.
Whatever. Let's just go. Quest added to scientific pursuits. Yep. Travel to the metro station so that we can walk above ground to Rivet City. You know, it's kind of odd that they made us go through all those metro tunnels because the outdoor environments look so awesome, and it's like, no, you can't go through the absolutely beautifully destroyed city. You have to go through these tiny linear tunnels that are all the same. It doesn't make much sense. I mean, I'm sure that they had some sort of reason, but it still seems kind of nonsensical to me. There we go. Frag grenade. Our explosive skill isn't particularly high, but I love using the frag grenade. It is just so much fun and, well, fun. It's also kind of cool once we get the plasma grenades. Plasma grenades are in this game, right? I'm thinking about New Vegas, and I'm pretty sure they're in here too. There we go. Haha! Exploded Centaur. Alright, time for you to die too. Oh, damn it. Okay. One more shot. And of course it flew too far back. Ugh. I hate that. Alright. Hunting rifle time. There we go. You're dead now. And there's a super mutant with a captive over there, if we can reach them in time. Oh. Yep. There we go. You are dead, my friend. Dead as a dead thing. Level up. Sweet. I enjoy leveling up. It is a very nice thing. Put a few points into barter. Some explosives, because they're fun. Maybe a little bit into lockpick, just because. Medicine. Small boost to science. Could use some extra in small guns. Probably two into energy weapons. Up to 40 in small guns, actually. Put the other two into repair. That should work. Guess I'll pick up Educated for the extra skill points in the future levels. And yes, the captive is still alive. Awesome. Because we can get karma boost.
Oh my god. I thought I was dead. You saved me. They dropped this stuff. Why don't you take it? It's all I have.
Now, we either have the choice of getting some minor loot or getting karma boost. I'll go for karma boost.
You'd know best, wouldn't you? I have to go. Again, thank you.
It's kind of funny. Last two playthroughs I've done, the captive has been female, but it's actually random whether it's male or not. I don't know why they did that. It's, I don't know, kind of neat that they bothered to put in voice acting for both genders. I don't normally expect any variety from voice acting in this game. But, well, evidently they cared enough to put it in here. That's, it's odd, but, I don't know, what the hell. Their game, they can do what they want. And there's, oh. Hello, Mirelurk. Yeah. I really hate the Mirelurks. Let's see. Hunting rifle. That'll work. For some more grenades. They're fun. Oh, of course, low AP. Generating AP. Plus, these guys are so slow that you can kind of do whatever to them as they run towards you. Don't do so well with a bunch of explosives in your face now, do ya? That's a little odd. Usually two grenades will do it just fine. Ha! Dead. Surprised that there's, like, this many remains of trees left. You'd think that everything would be destroyed from the trees, like they'd be vaporized, but apparently not. Of course, these damn little rad roaches. Luckily, I don't really run into them that often. Either there's not as many of them as there are in the early parts of the game, or I'm just lucky. I don't know. Hey. Discovered Dukov's place. That's always a kind of interesting little detour, anyway. There we go. Gonna blow up these rad roaches with the car, just because I feel like being cruel to rad roaches. Nuclear explode. Wait, did one of those survive? Holy shit, a car just exploded in your face! But then a 10mm bullet makes you explode, of course. Because that makes loads of sense. Whatever. Alright, let's go into Dukov's place for a moment here. Because it's a... This is one of the few places on the wasteland that's actually kind of clean. I find that interesting.
Who the hell are you? Never mind. You need a drink. Jerry, I'm thirsty over here.
And there's always that accent. Just like Moriarty, I'm guessing that they heard the accent on audio tapes or holodiscs or whatever, and they decided to imitate it for whatever reason, because they can't possibly be immigrants, not with that kind of accent. Who are these girls, and where are their clothes?
Ha ha! They're my party girls! I'm too much man for just one woman, so I need two! I wear them out every night. Why should they bother getting dressed when I'm just going to take it off?
That's certainly a philosophy.
Hey, watch your language, clown shoes. I don't pay them. They take care of me, so I take care of them. We'll rub each other wrong all night long.
The dialogue with this guy is just so funny. It's funny.
Don't let the door hit you in the ass, clown shoes.
Hi there, big boy. Oh my. Aren't you a stud? I'm Fantasia. If you need something, just let me know.
Like I said, it's just funny, because the dialogue is... It's so bad, but it's so hilarious.
He gives me some caps, but it's not what you think. He can be a nice guy. And when the lights go out, he's real fun.
Yeah, it's...
Later.
And of course, I'm wondering how you get a lighting fixture like that after a nuclear war. Maybe he already had it, but that's a kind of odd thing to have. Well, we are starting to come up on our time, so I'm going to take a short break. This is Dr. Horrible signing off. I will see you all next time.